Two mid-state cities have turned public spaces into living works of art, but they only blossom when the public participates. Smart Talk producer Mark Wallace has more.
Amidst the hustle and bustle of the city, Elizabeth Weaver adds her own contribution to the sights and sounds of Lancaster. She's hammering away on a custom-designed public piano at the corner of North Prince and West Chestnut Street. It's one of 20 scattered throughout downtown Lancaster as part of the Keys for the City program, a community initiative put forth by the nonprofit organization Music for Everyone.
You know, it's really transformed the city. You know, everybody's really embraced the pianos, and everybody said, oh, you know, won't they be vandalized, and how are people going to take care of them? And there's really hasn't been any problems, and that's the same experience I've had when I've done community mural projects. If you involve people enough in them, then they start to have their own ownership of it and take care of it.
Elizabeth's an artist and a musician, but you don't have to be to play the pianos. They're available for everyone.
It really breaks down that whole barrier of who's a musician and who's not, and that's really important to me because, you know, sure, I could say I'm a musician, but I feel like we're all musicians. We just have unfound potential, whether it's music or it's just like, you know, some blocks in the middle of the street that people can play on. It's like creating public space in any community is really, really essential, I think.
On that note, what about legal graffiti?
I've been fooling with this for a long time since I was reading a Vonnegut novel, The Mirror is a Leak to Another Dimension, and I just thought, why do we think of the surface on which graffiti or any sort of self-expression is put in public as so finite and something we got to fight? What if we embrace it, roll with it?
Jump Street, a nonprofit organization in Harrisburg, are trying to open a community doorway to many who perceive the world of art as inaccessible and closed to the masses. The pilot project is called The Peace Wall, funded by Arbor Education and Training. The Peace Wall slogan?
Analog meets digital and lives happily ever after. It is complicated, but it's very cool.
We'll get to the digital side in a minute, but first, to the Peace Wall. A 16 by 6 foot plywood wall stands inside the playground at 1801 North 3rd Street in Harrisburg, ready to be tagged, or spray painted as they say. It's legal and open to the public with a few rules.
Bring the positive, leave the negative out, you know. No gang signs, no racial slurs, no sexist stuff, you know. And these are the rules the kids came up with. So the casual user, the community person, it's just like, come in, get your own can of paint, come to wherever the wall is, in this case your neighborhood center, grab a can of paint, do what you want to do, come back the next day and see how yours weaves in with the other stuff, you know, how cool that, and then it goes away. And you go, now where did my tag go?
This is where it gets complicated, or cool, depending on how you look at it. When the wall's filled, the tags are photographed and the piece wall is whitewashed. From there, the images are uploaded to the website peacewall.net, and the next dimension, or multi-dimension, begins. The tags can inspire other artists. The users can merchandise their images onto t-shirts, coffee mugs, mouse pads, whatever. Or the image can be made into music. That's right, music from images. By assigning frequencies to colors and contrast within the photo through available software, you get this.
You just heard that image converted into sound.
Some simple audio editing, and you have the basis for a song spawned from your graffiti tag.
I now have samples that, if you listen to, can be turned into, perhaps, percussion, a drum kit. This can start off as a kick drum. If we ride that sound that's loaded in there, you can see on the spectrogram that it's turning into the original photo.
So you're saying people can paint on that wall and turn it into music?
Bingo. The peace wall doesn't start and end with a wall in the neighborhood somewhere. That's the springboard. If that's where you want it to end, if that's the experience for you, that's wonderful. But it can grow from so much more in this day and age.
For Smart Talk, I'm Mark Wallace.
WITF would like to see your creative side. Post videos of yourself playing the Lancaster pianos or tagging the graffiti peace wall at 1801 North 3rd Street in Harrisburg on WITF's Facebook page.
Hi, I'm Ayaya Isoki. I love the peace wall. This was so much fun. Everyone in the community should come down and put their piece on the peace wall.